Hey folks, Ryan Gunness here with MLMRecruitOnDemand.com. And today's video is I hate reverse recruiting people. I got a question from a prospect just recently. Actually, they sent this in through email. And I was going to respond to them, you know, just kind of a quick one-liner. And I kind of gave it a little bit of thought. And I said, I wonder how many people might have the same thought in their mind. So let me kind of turn this into a newsletter that we can all benefit from. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of read you the letter. I'm probably going to have this. You can print this out. I'll put a link to this under the video. So you can download this and print it out if you want to, you know, read it that way. Or you can just read it off your screen, however you want to do it. That's fine. So I'm just going to kind of read through the whole process here. So here's a question. Okay, so she said, hey, Ryan, I have been with one company for the past 5 years, and I'm happy and totally focused on what I'm doing. So reverse recruiting is not something I want to do. Can you explain further, Jan? Okay, so obviously she basically, what I'm hearing here is that she thinks that we're, you know, reverse recruiting. Some people say we're trying to steal people away from their company. You know, so that obviously doesn't sit well with a lot of people, including myself, because we're not trying to steal people away from that company. And I don't really look at it as reverse recruiting. And I'll explain to you, you know, why I say that. So here's my response. So I told Jan, hey, I was going to give her the one sentence answer, but let's turn this into a newsletter. So here we go. Jan, we're not asking people to leave their company and join yours. So because of that, I don't really consider this reverse recruiting. I like to think of it more like targeting people that have joined a network marketing business in the past. You see, most people that join a network marketing company end up inactive within less than 6 months. So the odds are that most people that you talk to are not going to be active with the company. Hence, they are free to join you. Okay, and I don't know if you know this statistic or not, but most people that join a network marketing company, you know, never go on to build a big business. Okay, they don't have access to a lot of the training that, you know, that you might have access to with the MLM Recruit On Demand system. So because of that, they never build a real business and they end up dropping out of the whole business completely. So most of the times, if you're calling a network marketing list, there's a chance, a good percentage of the people that you talk to are not going to even be with a company currently. All right, so let's jump into it here. And I even kind of give a little hint here. I say, hey, MLM Recruit On Demand, the simplest, most effective way to recruit experienced network marketers into your business. All right, so, and again, talking to network marketers, what I consider the best use of time. These people are sold on the industry, you know, just like yourself. And they got the bug. They got the bug and they're like, I need to figure out how to make this work. So if you're with a good company, you can provide good leadership and support, then you could help a lot of people win in the process, and then you win too as well, which I call a win-win situation. All right, now, on the flip side, you'll also come across people that are not open to looking at your opportunity because they're focused and they're happy with their current program, just like you're happy with your current program at the moment. Okay, and what we're gonna do with these people is we're gonna have respect. Okay, we're gonna, you know, have respect for them, and they're focused on their current program, so we're not gonna, you know, push our business down their throat. And we'll be able to offer them the MLM Recruit On Demand system as something that can help them. So we can invite them to take a look at MLM Recruit On Demand. Now, two things happen when you do that. Okay, and if you've been around some of my other training, you probably know what I'm going to talk about right now. Number one is when you invite someone to look at MLM Recruit On Demand, you know, there's a chance that you can make some money if they decide to join. So you're getting paid from someone that is not open to looking at your business anyway. Okay, I think that's pretty cool. Number two, you get a chance to keep in touch with them. This keeps the door open for you to invite them to try out some of your products or your services that you offer. Also, you know, if something wants to change down the road and they need to look for a new company, if you have a good relationship with them, obviously you'll have a better chance to recruit them in the future. Okay, it's all about building relationships. Okay, my point is, we are in network marketing. We're network marketers. Sometimes we forget that, like network work, which means we need to put in some time and effort. That's the work part of it. And we're marketers, so we're always communicating and connecting with people. So we have to work on our skills to do that effectively. Okay, and again, it's all about building relationships and networking with people. So if you use the MLM Rod system the way it's designed, you will be doing that in a big way. Plus, you'll be giving your team the same opportunity for them to do the same thing. All right, now to beat that point up a little bit more, here are two questions I want you to answer for yourself. So I want you to think about these two questions. Number one, is the company that you are currently with at this moment, is this the first company you have ever been, involved with? Is this the first company you have ever joined as far as network marketing? So think about that question for yourself. And number two, is your sponsor, the person that sponsored you into your current company, your current program right now, is that the first person that ever introduced you to network marketing? So think about that. All right, now, there's a 90% chance that your answer to these two questions is both a no. What that means is there's lots of quality, motivated people just like yourself that are waiting for you to come in their life. There are a lot of people right now that are not active, okay, right now, and they still believe in network marketing, and they're waiting for someone like yourself to show up with the right tools, the right skills, working on getting better to help guide them through that process. And that's where your job comes in. Your job is to go through the numbers and find them. So here's some real examples of the numbers, okay? If you invite 100 people to look at your business using the MLM Rod script, that I provide. Now, this is 100 people that you physically communicate with. You probably have to make a lot more calls. To get to talk to 100 people, you probably have to make 500, 600, 700 phone calls to talk to 100 people. Okay, now you should have at least 30% say yes to looking at your business. That's 30 people. You spoke to 100, 30 says, I'll take a look at what you have. If your number is less than 30, then you need to work on your skills. Nothing is wrong with the leads. It's something that's missing in your communication. 30 is is kind of the average. You can get actually higher than 30, but this is what we see across the board on the average side. 50% of the people say yes. So so the people that said, I'll take a look at what you have, 50% of those people, so 30 says yes, 50%, which is 15, half of the 30, should respond with a yes or no to a follow-up appointment with you. Okay, so that's 15 people either send you email, text, they call you, they leave a voicemail, and they said, okay, cool, I would like to talk to you further. Okay, if this number is less, then you need to tighten up your follow-up skills, because if you're looking at the script and you're using the script that I teach, I show you how to set an appointment with the people that are saying yes on the same call. And without doing that, you greatly reduce the amount of people that are actually going to be looking at your stuff, and you greatly reduce the amount of people that you're going to talk to on a follow-up. If you can't get them on a follow-up, nothing happens. All right, now 50% of the people that actually look should actually take your call and communicate with. So even though 15 people responded to you that they want to talk further, when you try to get in touch with those people, or if you set up an appointment ahead of time like I teach, you're not going to be able to get in touch with everybody. For some reason, some people disappear. Whatever happens, we don't know. All right, so that's 7 people that you can actually get on a follow-up call with and be able to have a decent conversation. So again, you spoke to 100, 30 says yes, and when it trickles down, you got 7 people that you're doing a follow-up with. All right, now, out of the people that you're doing a follow-up with, you should be signing up at least 20%. For the people that are doing a follow-up, they engage in your process, you should be signing up at least 20%. So 1 or 2 people, they either join you as a customer or a distributor. Okay, again, if this is less than 20%, then there's some kind of a problem in your follow-up process or the presentation that you're making or whatever tools that you're using to communicate your business. There will be something missing there. You should be getting at least 20%. And one good question that you could use for feedback is you could say, to the prospect, I mean, obviously you're talking to them, so you could say, "Hey, John, just to help me out here, do you mind sharing with me honestly why you are not moving forward? I will not take this personally against you. This is just my own personal education." So here are some of the numbers here. Just to kind of give you a recap so you can see it. 100 invited, 30 said yes, and okay, so I apologize there. I had to pause the recording for a second. Okay, so let me get back on track here. So 100 invited, 30 said yes to look. 15 actually look and responded with a yes or no to the follow-up with you. And 7 are reachable when you try to do a follow-up. 1 or 2 join. That's kind of a little snapshot recap. Now, these numbers above are focused on your primary business. I'm not factoring the people that will say no to you, no to looking at your business, but then they'll end up saying yes to looking at MLM Recruit On Demand. Okay, I'm just looking at your business here. Okay, so whatever you get as far as people looking at MLM Recruit On Demand is a bonus on top of everything else. All right, now let's talk about the time. 100 people invited. Now, if you're a P1 or P2 members, where we give you all the leads, you got a contact manager, you have the scripts, you have everything in front of you. Okay, if you're a P1, P2 member, you're going to probably need to call between 500 and 700 leads to actually talk to 100 people, which is about 7 to 10 hours. Okay, and the reason why you have to make that many calls is you're going to get a good percentage of disconnects, and you get a good percentage of people that don't return your call and stuff like that, because you're going to be leaving a lot of voicemails and whatnot. Okay, so 7 to 10 hours. Okay, now if you're a P3 member, where we call all the leads for you, then your time goes down a lot because we call all the leads for you, and so you're only going to be talking to the people that are actually calling you back or returning any missed calls or voicemails that you have and stuff like that. So about an hour if you're a P3 member. Okay, 30 say yes to looking at your business, which is about 3 minutes per person, so about 2 hours. So 30 say yes to looking at your business. You figure, to do the pitch like I teach it, it's a 3 minute call. It really shouldn't be more than that, maybe 4 minutes if you're a little bit slow in getting their email address. So 30 people, about 2 hours. 15 look and respond with a yes or no to your to a follow-up call with you. Okay, so that's 2 minutes per person, about 30 minutes. 7 are reachable. Okay, so this, let me break this down a little bit for when you, after you do the call, getting the emails and all that stuff, that's why I added that extra 2 minutes there, just to get a firm email and all that good stuff from them. All right, 7 are reachable when you try to do a follow-up call. So when you contact back the people that said yes to looking, and you get in touch with about half of them, you figure that follow-up call is about a 15-minute call, maybe 20 minutes, but you shouldn't really do more. Most of that call is just basically answering any little questions they have, and then recommending another resource, whether it's a video to talk that talks more about the product, an opportunity video, maybe even a quick three-way call with an upline or something like that. And you're recommending something else. You're inviting them to come to a conference call, a webinar, some other resource that you have that can educate them about the whole business that you have. All right, so 7 people you do that with, that's about 2 hours. Okay, and then 1 or 2 join. 5 minutes per person. So when they're ready to join, you keep inviting them to more resources to get educated in the process. And when they're ready to join, it's a pretty quick process. Most companies you could sign up with, you go online, you could walk them through the sign-up process, but that's a 5 minute session. You shouldn't try to turn that into a long session either. All right, now that is about 10 minutes. You're gonna probably send them a welcome email and all that good stuff. Welcome to the team, get them resources to the team calls and everything that you have going on. So total time, if you're a P1 or P2 member, it's about 15 hours to sponsor 1 or 2 people. Okay, if you are a P3 member, that goes down to about 5 hours because you're saving a bunch of the time that it takes to actually make all the calls. That does eat up a lot of your time. Okay, so that's kind of a snapshot. Now also keep in mind, I'm lowballing the numbers here. If you have if you have your skills down pack, if you got the invitation conversation down pack and your follow-up conversation, all that stuff, then your number should at least double. Okay, so I just wanted to lowball it. I want to be very, very realistic here. And you know, some people, I mean, this is not pretty. 15 hours to sponsor one or two people. This is work, the network marketing, okay? But also the big picture is your income continues to grow. So as you keep doing this process and you're adding more customers and distributors to your team, your income continues to grow and grow and grow. You know, assuming that you're with a company that has the residual income component built into it, then you know, in the beginning, this is you know, you do a lot of work for, you know, minimal results. But as you continue that process, your income continues to grow and grow and grow and grow. So you get paid on things that you're not doing anymore. All right, so that's pretty much my you know, my audio version of this. If you wanna, you know, if you're the type of person that like to read or print this out or whatever, there should be a link to this PDF down below, and you can print that out and stick it up, read it a few times, whatever, and then go to work. All right, go start picking up the phone and connecting with people, invite them to look at your business, and just repeat the process over and over again. Hope this was helpful. Ryan Gunness signing out.